morning, I'm Oasis. Rochelle. How you know Rochelle?
Yes, of course.
Are you like friends?
I am a frequent visitor at Oasis Cafe. I come here like 3 times.
Do you like pay your rent here?
Something like that.
You're always here. Well, I don't blame you. They have really good coffee.
So what are we having today?
How is the lovely Nissa? I haven't seen Nissa in a long time.
She's good. She's doing good.
Yes. Love. So I want something. In the morning, this is my ritual. I gotta have some coffee. I'm like, this is not. So I travel like migraine headaches and serious headaches.
Okay.
And so some people, caffeine is really good for you, or caffeine is not good for you.
Right.
Thankfully, caffeine is good for me. And as soon as I drink coffee, my headache is like starts to diminish.
It does work for you.
Yes. So in the morning I must have. It's like Viagra for me.
Oh wow.
I must have my morning. Yeah. You've heard of Viagra?
Yes, I have.
It's like my morning. It's
I
like
don't
my
take mo- it personally, yeah. but.
I may have to start soon. 50, maybe. 50. So I'd like some of your coffee. Why don't you recommend some nice coffee
for me? Do you like it strong or weak?
Do you like it strong
Tall, or weak? Dark, and strong.
Wow. Okay.
So we'll have two of those. So, everyone who's watching A Day in the Life, we're with the lovely Joelle Ganchan.
Hi.
And we're still currently at Oasis Cafe.
So waiting in our coffee.
Waiting in our coffee. So we're gonna find out a bit more about Joelle.
Sure.
So Joelle, tell us, you know, who are you exactly? Why are you in Ghana? Why are you so lovely all the time?
Do you think I'm lovely all the time?
I do.
You should see me in the mornings when the wrinkles are coming up. This is all MAC. I'll tell you, a lot of people always say, what are you doing? Because of course, for most of my life, I was raised outside of Guyana. And then, so about 5 years ago, bacon sausage, you gotta love it. About 5 years ago, I came here, something completely different, to do a show, to perform at a show. And then I just got in touch with the right people. I went to NTN and I visited, and a fantastic relationship started. And before you know it, I started doing TV.
Right.
And then I would come and I would spend 2-3 months and so on.
This is actually
and
then, his phone is going off.
Yes, and it's something from GT&T, top of 500. Not bad.
Right.
Anyway, and before you know it, I just start getting more and more contracts, and people are asking me to do more and more work.
Because you're fabulous,
and of course, I've done TV previously to come into Guyana, in the US and stuff like that. My greatest strength would be kindness. My greatest weakness will be kindness.
So Joelle, what are you currently doing right now? Because you are a TV and radio personality.
Right.
So what are you doing currently in Ghana?
Well, I live here full-time, of course, and I do shows, and believe it or not, people think I have like a full-time job outside of TV. I don't, because I really have eight TV shows in a 7-day period.
Eight.
On Sundays, there are 2 shows, morning and night, on NTN, of course.
So you're 24 hours a day.
Yes, because you got to plan, and then my wardrobe, it really is a lot of work.
There you go.
Lovely, thank you. It just got here. Okay, just arrived from Ethiopia, my coffee. Life is good. I love Oasis.
I know.
This is good stuff.
And you can have, we change it every day.
Lovely. Can I have a, yeah. Lovely.
So we have our chicken puffs.
Thank you. So nice. All right,
so you normally begin your days.
I do.
With a cup of coffee, like you said.
I do. I have to have coffee. Remember, I told you earlier.
It's your morning Viagra.
It is my morning Viagra.
Yes.
And
that statement keeps.
You like that?
I keep hearing it in
you
my
like
head.
That? Yes. There's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with the word Viagra. But when I get up in the morning, the first thing I say, I really do this. Thank you, God.
Yes.
Because when we wake up in this day and age, or every day and age, especially now, what's going on in this world, you wake up, you see the light of day, you thank God.
Yes, you do. You
and
should
then,
at least.
And then you find something to bitch and complain about.
So should we do a cheers?
To
E1. Yes, A Day in the Life of Joelle.
A Day in the Life of Joelle Ganchan. Let's see this. Oh, so Ethiopian.
Oh, wow. You sold me on the coffee, by the way.
Do you like that?
Yes, I love it.
Drink more coffee from Oasis.
I love it.
Yes.
So tell us about your childhood.
Oh,
what
gosh.
Was your childhood like?
Rough.
Rough.
Yeah, I did have. Yes, I did have. But you know what?
And why was it so rough?
I had a rough. My parents got divorced when I was like 1. Of course, there's been turmoil for a few years until everything is leveled off. But I'm glad. I wouldn't change it. Right. Because I think if it was any different, perhaps I wouldn't have been the strong person. Because I honestly can't think of anyone, and I say that with all convictions, I can't think of anyone that can break me. How many times have I been on my TV show and people call and be derogatory? Right. And I say, thank you very much for your opinion, but most of all, thank you for watching.
Yeah, of course. Like, haters are gonna hate,
I can't let, and I won't let anyone break me. I am empowered. Right. I am my destiny. I'm the driver of my destiny.
Right. So you do believe that everything happens for a reason?
I do. And I've gone past that. And you know, when you have a little rough childhood, you can either go in either direction. You can go in either direction, I should say. You can become a drug addict. You can turn to liquor. You can turn to all these kind of stuff. Or you can say, listen, I'm going to prove that this is what I come from, but this is where I'm heading. Enough. No.
I like that.
I think everything in this world has a yes to it. You just have to create and find a way to do the yes. Yes, so I don't like the word no. When I think about all the bad times that I've had, why would I want to go there? I want to head in a different direction. So you can either, it's either good or bad. Correct. Since I've had the bad, I, you know, decided
you
to head to good.
You taste the bad, now you want to taste, or you want to taste the good.
Correct.
So what were your teenage years like, since you just told us about your childhood?
Well, you know, I went to the U.S. I went to school, believe it or not. I went to school. I dated a lot. Girls.
You dated girls?
I did. Okay. Beauty queens. I dated a few beauty queens, even right here from Guyana when I was younger. Because what happened, in my younger days, I was frequently, every time I had a vacation, come here. I had my family here. I was very close to my mom's family.
Right.
And so I would come here and I would go out. And believe it or not, I really had a good body back then. And it was nice hair and whatever. You know, 1920. I dated a few beauty queens and women and whatever.
Mm-hmm. And then?
And then, you know.
Your interest changed?
No, just, I was married. Everyone knows that.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Oh, you didn't know that. Look at you. I got married, I was 21. And it was the best experience. Absolutely best. I've had 5 years of fantastic marriage.
Okay.
Fantastic. Wouldn't change it. Wouldn't go back. I've made a lifetime friendship.
I was going to say, I was just going to ask you if you didn't mind me asking.
Oh,
if
God.
You're still friends with your ex.
Completely. Oh. Wouldn't have it any other way. She's remarried. And we're all so close,
oh,
and we can count on each other.
That's nice.
And we have so much between us, and so much appreciation. And I think it's because I've been, like, when I felt that the marriage didn't work for me,
right,
for whatever reason, I was honest to sit with her, though we were sitting,
right,
and have say, this is what's going on, and this is, and she's not, she's a smart, educated, beautiful woman. Still is.
Is and she gonna be watching this?
Of course I have to send her the, are you kidding me?
Yes, of course.
And so I explained to her, and I think she appreciated the honesty. This is how the story went, right? There's not like another version, is there? No, and I think she appreciated the honesty.
Right.
So I felt like they were missing parts of my life.
Right.
So I needed to go find what that is. Mm-hmm. And she said to me, and I remembered distinctly, she said, find what is missing. Let me help you find that. Every person I've ever dated, I'm still in contact. We hang out, we talk, we at Christmas, at birthday, always, and whatever, however we get in touch with each other. I have no enemies with the ex. I have
fantastic
love and helpful, and I'm always help, and they know they can call me, hey, I need a favor, da 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 da, and that's just, I don't think if it doesn't work, that we need to fight and be abusive to each other,
right,
and become enemies.
Right.
Because at one time we shared so much.
Shared so, right, many happy times,
right,
with each other.
And when you lay in bed and you're like, I really love you and I really love you. And so because something didn't work, what happened to all that that we talked about during the year, whatever time we've dated?
Right.
You know?
Makes sense. So Joelle, I want to thank you for allowing us to,
absolutely,
you know, be part of your morning routine here at Oasis Cafe. It's a day in the life of Joelle Ganchen. So Joelle, what is our next stop, or where is our next stop?
I got to run to the studio for about a few minutes.
Okay.
Then I have to get my nails.
Yes.
And then I got a few things. Why, you want to come?
Yes, I definitely do.
Are you serious?
If you would like to have us come along.
E1? They're coming with me.
E1's stalking you for the day.
Yes.
So yes, a day in the life here on E1 with Joelle Ganchen.
This is YKC
for Inside the 592
on eNetworks
channel E1.
What's up, Guyana? This is Angela Hunt. You're tuned in to Inside the 592 on E1.
Hi everybody, you're at NT, and of course where I do my television shows nightly. It's called Bedtime Songs, you know, Michaela.
Bedtime Songs.
That's right. Come, let me take you into my world. Come. So basically, this is the NT Institute, and this is of course where I do my show every night. That quick little mirror is my last minute check right there, you know, the face to make sure everything is good. And of course, this is television studio. So once I'm ready and everything like that, for those of you who don't know TV, then I come, I take my little seat, I read over my notes, I make sure I position myself properly, I sit erect so that way my stomach doesn't show like I'm overweight and then I look skinnier, you know what I mean? You gotta try to hide all that stuff when you're on TV. And then I hold a certain pose. That's important, that is so important. You don't want to look like a big slob. And then of course in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, I get a signal from next door. And then I say, hi everybody, good evening to all of you, and welcome to the show that's all about you. This is Bedtime Songs, live from our NTN studios in Georgetown. It's been a fantastic day. Today is Monday, sunny and bright. I'm ready to entertain you for the next 1 hour. Sit back, relax, and enjoy. Oh, forget that. Kick off your shoes because we're going to have a real good time, y'all. This is Bedtime Songs. And of course, we want to end it soon. And then I go into all of that good stuff. And I start yapping, talk a little about me. Gotta talk about me a little. And then I take it from there. So it's very, very simple. And of course, like I've said before, I like stuff that are totally unscripted, because scripted TV is so prepared and then you feel like you're acting, and I don't want to act, you know what I mean? Of course, I have like little notes, little reminders, right? Like a one word line or stuff like that, so I know what to do. And then I take it from there. And then, of course, before you know it, I love what I'm doing, you enjoy it, and we're all happy. A project manager.
Okay.
Any project. I'm a fantastic planner, but I can execute flawlessly. Ooh, I love the 80s. Indian or English?
Both.
Oh gosh. Oh, I love anything Whitney. I can't think of one. Oh, Where do broken hearts go? Way too broken. You know that song.
Of course, I know Whitney.
Yeah, love her. Indian. Oh God, there's so many Indian songs. Would you know them if I said one?
Probably not.
No. Yeah, all the Indian older songs I love. So Michaela, my future wife.
Oh wow.
There you go.
We're engaged. Would,
yes.
Well, I don't.
My future wife. So yeah. After we would have done my TV show and stuff, like whenever I have to do radio, the radio station is downstairs, NTN 89.1 FM, the Pulse of Guyana. Do you have a pulse? Gosh, we have. Hope you have a pulse. So I'm going to take you downstairs and give you a quick glimpse of the radio station. Don't you just love it? Love it.
This life is great.
A day. One day. One day in the life.
Well, if you want to follow us for a week and follow you for a week, we can do that.
It would be fun. Could you imagine? It would be. I get too tired.
There's a lot of wardrobe changes.
Come, E1. First, we got to do the security check. Oh, it says no.
Thank you.
Oh, finally, we're verifying. Hello, Somo.
We're continuing a day in the life of Joel Ganchan at NTN Radio. He's about to show us the studio where he does his thing. How often?
Twice a week. I like the radio show. Oop, I'm getting another phone call. My mom, this is not one I would want to take on the TV, but come on and let me show you what I do in terms of radio here at NTN.
Hi, it's me again. You can't get enough of me, or I can get enough of you. Anyway, so Michaela.
I can't get enough.
Thank you, Michaela. So my good friend Michaela has been with me. Thank you very much for putting up with me so long. So we've seen TV, and this is actually the NTN radio station. 89.1 FM, the
beat of Guyana, heartbeat of Guyana.
No,
is that right?
Go ahead.
Oh, the pulse
you
of Guyana.
You can't cheat.
The pulse of
Guyana. Of Guyana.
Sorry.
Some people, so hard to teach them this stuff. All right, so we come here. I'm sure many of you have seen radio before, and I sit here. Usually I have someone that helps me.
Right, I know. An assistant on the
yes,
radio.
They're so good. The guys are
you
so
the
good.
Only one that has an assistant on the radio? I have a feeling that you are.
Yes, how do you know?
Like
Mark here and all the guys are so versed and they know everything.
Right.
But I'm
the one. You need help with the controls.
Yeah, you control and let me talk.
Yes. Right. I love it.
You know that. So then I'll go in here, obviously, and I say, hello, good morning, Guyan, and how are you? And da da da, and talk about what's going on. And then we start taking
so
calls.
So, what's your radio program about? What's it like?
It's music, it's chit chat, it's people talking to you. Okay. You know, then I like to do like the gripe of the day, like what really annoys me. Right. So I like to talk about.
So when are you on the radio? What days and what times?
On Mondays and Wednesdays.
Tune in to Joel Monday and Wednesday. At what time?
At 2 p.m.
At 2 p.m.
on NTN. I love it. Absolutely love it. It's good relaxation and stuff like it's different than TV.
Right.
Because of course you can run in here all sloppy and whatever.
Oh, I know all about the radio.
Yeah, right? Yeah. And so nobody sees you. You don't have to put on the 150 pounds of makeup.
Right.
Not me. I don't wear makeup.
No, not at all.
Not at all. And then, of course, I have on my headset because I feel real when I have this on.
Oh, I feel real when I have mine on, too.
You do.
It's like, necessary to have the headphones.
I've seen, like, other radio announcers and stuff, right? They don't need this. But for me, right, Mark? Mark, you need that, too. Mark here says he needs that.
Hey, he's Mark here.
And so I would do this, and then I'll be like...
You look fabulous with your headphones on, by the way. I love it.
Exactly.
Screw the bulb and stir. Screw the light bulb and stir the pot.
There you go. And so that's basically it.
Yeah,
and then I do my 1 hour and then I leave. We're gonna roll it because we're at NTN. This is energy. I do.
Roll it down by Allison Hynes.
Allison, she's fantastic.
Teach me how to roll it.
She's so fast. I don't know if I know how to roll it at my age. But okay, so when we're here, we want energy when we're at NTN, all right, Mark?
Yes.
You ready?
Yes. What do I do first? Oh, we're doing a fine wine. Okay.
Wait, no, Michaela.
Oh.
You gotta move your hips.
Oh, okay.
You give a little shake.
Oh, wow.
Right? And then you.
Oh, by the way, we did not choreograph this.
No.
This is natural.
Song. Come. And now we're gonna turn.
Okay.
We're gonna...
Oh wow.
There you go. Nice. Yeah. And there it is.
I got it.
The simple
we rolled it.
We rolled it.
We rolled it very well.
We rolled it. Hi, you're watching E1, that's right, and they're doing A Day in the Life with me, Joel Gunshaw, you believe it? So, we've been at TV, we've been radio, and now we're going to redefine beautiful. Check me out at Nalini's Beauty Parlor. That's next on A Day in the Life with Joel Gunshaw. Come with me, come follow me.
This is YKC
for Inside the 592
on E Networks
channel E1.
What's up, Guyana? This is Angela Hunt. You're tuned into Inside the 592 on E1.
So E, as promised, I'm going to bring you in to my secret. This is how, where I come once a week, Michaela.
Once a week.
Do you go to the beauty parlor?
Yes,
all?
Once
you
a
do.
Week.
Once
yes.
a week. You're once a week.
At least
sometimes
once a week.
Twice. Depends on if you're going
to
go out.
To do.
Correct. And so this is where I come like once a week to get my doodid
okay,
and my nails done. My doodid and my, okay. Yes, and just to get a little brush up and stuff. So right. I'm making a quick stop into the fabulous Nalini's. You know Nalini's has been around for...
I've been coming here since I was a little girl.
Yeah, so there you go. There you go. So come follow me. Follow me. Come with me. Hi, everybody. It's me again. You tired of me yet? But guess what? I'm like an ink stain. I'm not going anywhere. You got more to come. That's right, because you're watching E1, E-Fabulous, E-Energy. I absolutely love it, of course. This, you're watching A Day in the Life with me. All right, we're trying to cover most things today, but you know the other things is for late night. Anyway, I'm at one of the places that I absolutely love, and I always make a quick pit stop. Sometime once, sometime twice, sometime three times a week. When you're at my age, are you kidding me? I should either move in here or at least build a beauty parlor within my house. But anyway, I'm here for a quick fix because for some reason when it comes to my nails, I can't keep it. I just can't keep it. I was just telling Michaela.
Yes.
The lovely Michaela is next to me. Can you see her? Say hi, Michaela, from here. Stretch your hands. There you go.
Hi.
That's Michaela. You've seen her. She's been following me all day. Are you tired yet?
No, definitely not.
You're not tired yet.
I'm getting there, but not tired.
You're getting there. Yes. All right, because yes. we still have more to do.
Yes.
I think we got more stops coming up, right?
Yes.
We're going shopping right after this. So you're watching E1. I'm getting my little polish. I think Nalini's Nods is always doing me. My nails.
Yes.
And of course, the other girls are all fabulous too. They're always helping me out. Now, Nalini's, of course, has, you said, since you were like eight, it's been around for a long time. It's old. Nalini's old in a good way. It's an institution. I like that. So Nalini's, the beauty parlor institution. Y'all watching E, everybody. And this is A Day in the Life with me. Fabulous. Fabulous, you think? Yeah, not bad. Look fabulous. This is what you call Fabulous Nails by Nalini's. Redefining beautiful has never been more easier. Check out Nalini's today. Probably be so devastated that so many people have been unfortunate and that I've been given life. And I would probably, if there were, if the they were all next to me. Somehow, I will make sure I go through and poke everyone to make sure that they're alive. I wouldn't leave without knowing that there's nothing I can do. In between all of them.
This is YKC
for Inside the 592
on E-Network's
channel E1.
What's up, Guyana? This is Angela Hunt. You're tuned in to Inside the 592 on E1.
Hey everybody, so this is my final stop. Of course, me and my friend here, Michaela, has been traveling all day. And so with everything, a little shopping is just what we need.
Yes, a little retail therapy, like they call it.
Absolutely. So where else than the newly constructed, good word, thank you for that, Mall by the Beepot. So we want to say thanks to, and congratulations to the Beepot,
Monica Beepot.
She's fabulous.
Always looks fabulous.
She dresses fabulous.
Yeah, she does.
She knows her stuff.
Impeccable taste.
She knows her stuff. And this is why I think this mall is going to be fabulous, because I know a lot of stuff or items that come into this mall, she has a say in it.
Yes.
And she has good taste.
She has great taste.
So, E, come on in with me. Let's go shopping and let's see what we can find at Giftland Mall.
Hopefully we can find some makeup and some hats and some, you know, handbags and stuff like that. And some picture frames.
That's exactly why I have her with me. Come on, let's go. So I've begun my shopping spree. Hey everybody, how are you? And of course,
Joe has fans everywhere he goes.
I know, but can I tell you, I am pleasantly surprised. We spoke earlier about Monica and her taste, but here's the thing. So if you were to want just a few decorative pieces to enhance your home, check this out. My favorite, is it your favorite? Rum and Coke.
Rum and soda.
Do we like Merlot? Everybody was Merlot. Very, very classy. Yes. Love it. Yes. Then we got whiskey. Yes. And of course, we're drunk. We wake up in the morning and we need a little cafe latte.
Yes.
Coffee latte. Absolutely. There's so many things. It's like heaven. This is what you call shopping heaven. And guess what? I've noticed her. She thinks I don't notice her. Right here, the fabulous and fierce and fantastic Monica Beepot. Weren't we just talking about her behind her back?
We were actually. I do hope
it's good things.
No, it was good things.
No, yes, excellent things.
So congratulations to you and your family.
Thank you very much.
And I know this has been in the making for a long time, and I know the logistics and the hard work and the dedication that you've put together.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Are you proud?
Absolutely proud. Proud to be a Guyanese.
Yes, mm-hmm. To do this.
To do this.
To embark on this.
Absolutely.
It's a huge undertaking.
Huge.
Yes. How long? I know I don't want to get all up in your business, please. I do. But how long did it actually take you from the conception to now?
7 years.
It's clean family fun, which the entire family can partake in. So again, two thumbs up to you guys.
Thank you very much.
And to your family. Good to see you, baby.
Bye-bye. Mwah.
honesty. Something I've never told anyone else. My body is starting to sag. It's true. I'm like, you were up here. What are you doing down there? No, move on up. Let's see what else is going on. So who needs Miami when you have all this?
You have Miami.
Yes, you do, you do. Gotta love it. Thank you, Michaela. You are watching E! And this is One Day in the Life with me, Joel Gansha, and my new bride, Michaela.